into your gentle Hatha. In our gentle Hatha practice, we will be doing some mindful, slow, gentle movements in the body, letting the energy open up through the day. Sometimes we just need to have a little bit of loving, grounding, but still soft movement in the body. And I'm going to call for the use of at least one bolster, if not a couple bolsters, a set of foam blocks and a drip foam block. If all you have is your own body and the surface you practice on, no problem. You can modify and adapt as needed. So we're going to start lying on our backs, and I'm going to take my bolster underneath my knees. So that way my lower back and hips have a little bit more cushiness as I lay down. Now, if you just woke up or you're feeling a little bit sleepy, you might opt for a seated position. And you'd rather stay a bit more conscious or alert. Otherwise, let yourself take a breather, making connection with the earth, connection to your mat or the floor that you practice on. Press your shoulders down your back, let the legs turn out, the arms face, palms face up, down by your sides. And just notice the natural rise and fall of your belly. You can place your hands both around the belly, let the belly rise into the palms. Taking one more breath out the mouth, nice and cleansing. I'm going to take the sound of Om once to open the practice. Start to use your bend your knees, use your feet to tug the bolster towards you as you lift your hips up and take your sacrum over top of your bolster now. Now from here you can take your soles of your feet together, let the knees open a bit wider into reclining butterfly. You take your elbows wide and take your palms up overhead and make a diamond, a double diamond shape here. Breathing in, breathing out. You might feel a little stretch and opening of the psoas in the front of your hip flexors, the pelvis, all the ligaments around there. Breathing in. Send your breath to where you wish for it to be more present. another breath like this. And then walk your feet to the ground. Let your knees windshield wipe a little bit from side to side with the bolster still beneath you. Good, and then take your right leg, outer edge of the right foot on top of the left thigh, but beneath your thread the needle. Lift your left foot off the mat and interlace your hands around your left thigh or left shin below the knee. Flex your right foot a bit more and rock your sacrum and pelvis from side to side. Breathing into that right hip and glute, especially if you're coming from sleeping, if you're practicing in the morning, or maybe at the end of the day, winding down. Both are applicable. Another breath here, inhale, and exhale. Good, from there you can switch sides, crossing the outer edge of the left foot on top of the right thigh with the knee. Breathing in. And out. From there, release your left leg, bring your arms up and legs up to the ceiling for a brief legs to sky, Viparita Karate. Feeling the reverse flow of energy, your blood, your lymphatic fluids. For a few more breaths, really take in the inhales with the exhales. And then begin to move through the wrists and the ankles. And then take your hands on your ankles, around your shins. Let the knees open wide, pulling the hands down the ankles and shins into Happy Baby. Breathing into your inner thighs. Bend, knees bend, hug everything into center. Take your hands around your knees and let your knees circle in one direction, lubricating around the hip and the pelvic girdle, and then reverse direction, going the other way in the equal amount. Come in the touch and your feet go wide, so you're in an inverted butterfly position. few breaths there, letting the hips sink into the pelvis further. Windshield wiper gently from side to side a little bit more. Lift your hips up, take the bolster off to the side for now, and start to roll the spine down vertebra by vertebra until your whole spine is back on your mat in one piece. Send your left leg out in front of you, and gather your right knee in towards your chest, and breathe into your thigh, into your chest, into your abdominals, apanasana, beneath the chest pose. Nothing too hard. You don't want to be too harsh on the hips. If there's compression of the bones connecting and there's no sensation at all, then go around that sensation or lack thereof and find something a bit more juicy as you breathe into it. Come to a little twist, taking the left hand to the outside of the right knee. And then the right arm can be in a T shape or a cactus shape, whatever keeps your right shoulder firmly on the ground. Shift your hips to the right an inch and take an inhale. Exhale to let the legs fall over to the left. Gaze over to the right for a deeper twist. Inhale back to center, lift your hips back to the middle of the mat and hug your knees in. Send your right leg out in front of you, let your left thigh come in towards your chest, breathing in and breathing out. Take your right hand outside of your left knee, left elbow and shoulder supporting the ground below. Pick your hips up to the left slightly as you breathe in again. Exhale, twist over to the right. Keep your shoulder fastened to the ground, turn your gaze to the left if you like. Inhale to center, bring your hips back to center and hug your knees into your chest. let your head come back down to the mat. And then bring your feet down to the ground. From here, roll over to your left hip. Press down through your right hand. And come up to your seat. Now, if you have that bolster handy, take underneath your sitting bones. We'll just take a little series for the spine. Sit as comfortable as you like. It doesn't have to look a certain way. Let it be your way. Place your palms down on your thighs or your knees. And inhale, tip your pelvis forward with your chest up into a seated cow position. Exhale, round your spine into a seated cat. Go back and forth between both the actions of the spine. Breathing into your lungs. And then from there, go ahead and take your torso to the right. Inhale as you lean forward towards center. Exhale from center to back up to neutral. Inhale. Exhale. Three more of these. Emphasizing your movement in the lower back. Good, then inhale, lift up to center. And then exhale to your left. Inhale, center. Exhale, to center, to the middle. Inhale, to the right. Exhale, to center. Inhale. And exhale. A couple more. Center and inhale. Exhale. Good. And then from there, take your left hand out to the side. Have your palm anchored on the mat. Press down through your sit bones equally as you inhale. Plug your right shoulder into your back and reach the arm up and over towards the left. Find that lengthening from your right hip bone, sit bone, out to your right fingertips, all the way into this nice arc. Roll your shoulders back, open your chest more, maybe look towards the right a bit and up to the ceiling. Breathe into your right lower back. Center to the right. Reach your left arm out, up, and over towards the right. More breaths like so. inhale to center. Take your right hand to your left thigh, knee, tent your left fingertips behind you, and inhale, lift your chest up. Gentle resistance as you now rotate around your spine to the left. Breathe in through your entire spine. Center, take your left hand to your left knee, right hand behind, counter twist to your right. Now take your left hand to your right thigh, keep your right fingertips behind as you lift up. And then exhale to the right. Inhale once again. Exhale, twist more to the right. Inhale, center. And then exhale, find your seated cat shape again. And then inhale, seated cow. Good. Take a brief stretch through the neck. Bring your left ear to your left shoulder. Bringing your chin down to your chest. Roll your right shoulder back and breathe in through the right side of your neck. Carefully roll your chin down to your throat until the right ear comes towards the right shoulder. Inhaling and exhaling. Back to your throat. Let your head roll back. Come off of your bolster, take it off to the left side. Make your way to your hands and your knees. Once you come to your hands and your knees, you can start to find this a little bit more cat and cow. Hips back, chest forward. And then exhale around the spine, chin to throat, lift up through your ribs. Back and forth, inhale, and round, go a little bit from side to side, lateral flexion, hips one way, torso the opposite, start to move a little bit more freestyle, cat-cow, figure eight, little barrel rolls. And then from there, flip your hands to your fingers face toward your knees, wrist face toward the front of the mat. And then start to lean your way back a little bit, and forth, back, and forth, breathing in, Good. Release one hand and then the other hand and shake out the wrist, fingertips. Good. And then from there, go ahead and take the tops of the hands down, palms the face up, and breathe into your hands, your wrists, and forearms. And then shake out the wrists, shake out the fingertips. Find a toe squat for a few breaths. Bring your bum to your heels. Have the toes tucked underneath you. If you'd like to take a block between your bum and heels, that can help support the toe squat a bit more for the duration you're here. And then try to bring all 10 toe pads tucked underneath you. That's for 5. For 4. 3. 2. For 1. Good. And we'll stay here for a few more breaths. Bring the arms up overhead. Take your right hand to your right shoulder. Left hand can come on the right elbow. And then roll your shoulders back together and breathing in as you push the right elbow and the left hand against each other, finding traction for the right arm, tricep, and breathe. Slowly release and take the left fingers to the left shoulder. Use the right hand on the left elbow and breathe into them. Your left arm down, shake up your arm, shake up your hands, and you can take your block to the side and then roll out the ankles, roll out the toes. Bring the tops of your feet down to the mat, tent your fingertips on either side, and then lean back into your insteps of your feet as you start to dorsal flex the ankle stretch and breathe in. Return to your shins, take your hands onto your mat, and then you can start to stretch one leg back, tucking those toes, and then switch sides. And from there, step your feet forward one at a time, and then take your hands to your shins, finding a brief standing forward fold. Tent your fingertips, step your left foot back, and bring your right knee a little bit more over that right ankle. Now you can lower your left knee down to the mat for a low lunge, or I'm going to offer right away a high lunge by walking the hands up to the right thigh, lifting up to your chest and torso. And then from there, reach your arms out, plug your shoulders into their sockets, and reach your arms up towards the ceiling as you sit into this nice, straightforward Anjaneyasana, high crescent lunge. Stretch out through your left toes, lift up through your waist, breathing in. Sinking lower as you breathe out. As you exhale, take your hands on your hips, turn your left toes out wide to the back edge of the mat, turn the toes slightly in, and then bend your right knee and thigh and take your arms out of line with your shoulders for warrior two. Virabhadrasana B. Sink into your thighs, hug into your legs, and push away through your feet all at the same time. Charge the entire lower body. Keep that pelvic floor zippered in and up by contracting in through your sit bones, lower abdominals, hug your ribs in. Reach your fingertips out nice and long. Sit a little bit lower if you have the space and depth to sit lower. And then from there you can turn your palms up to the ceiling and inhale, reach your right arm up to the ceiling for exalted warrior. One more breath here. Inhale back to warrior two. Extend your right leg. And then from there, turn your palms to face forward, bend your right knee, turn your left toes to face the front of the mat once again. Then walk your left foot up a little bit until you can step it forward and then switch sides as you take your right foot back. Stay in your low lunge if you wish with the right knee down on a block or on your mat, or walk your hands up your left thigh, sit into your left thigh, push off your right toes more, and then reach your right arm, left arm up overhead. As you sit into your left thigh, push off your right toes more. Firming your belly, wrapping your ribs in. Continue lifting up through your fingertips as you sit more through your left thigh. Exhale. Lift up a little bit higher, reach out to that right hip and thigh, keep your abdominals in, low ribs, pull it back. Then take your hands to your hips, carefully turn the right toes out through the wide edge of the mat. Sit and walk your left foot in a little bit if you need. And then sitting into that left thigh, nice and low. Get your arms out in line with your shoulders to warrior two. Second side. Pull your hips in and up to their sockets, centering into the pelvic floor and pelvic bowl. Now sitting into your legs, push your feet away from each other. At the same time, pull them in at the same time. Continue reaching out through your fingertips, breathe in. And out. Bring the palms up to the ceiling as you reach your left arm up to the ceiling, maybe past the head, behind to the floor, to the mat behind you. And the right hand can come behind your right thigh to support. Breathe. One more breath. Exhale, coming out slow and controlled. Now from there, turn your palms down to either side of that left foot, turn your right foot to face the front, but this time slide your left leg back into downward dog, or child's pose, or hands and knees if down dog is not accessible to you. Spread your toes, spread your fingers, dome your hands and your feet. Bend your knees as you reach your hips back and up, let your chest bow down towards your thighs. One more breath and you're down dog. Coming forward now to your hands and your knees, tabletop position. Once you find tabletop position, come down to your forearms. And bring your elbows out in front of you for Sphinx posture. Getting more into that low back. Our low back tends to seize up from lots of sitting or long held static positions, especially when we're sleeping overnight. So it's nice to bring some compression and some pressure into the low back and to find more space from that. So press down through the tops of the feet as you spread the toes wide. Feel the ilium, the waist bone, continue to push down without any over pressure, just at the right amount. And then breathing in through your spine, through the crown of your head. Inhale. And exhale. Now, if you want to find seal posture, be very mindful as you lift your elbows off the ground, keep your palms flat, your arms extended, keep pushing back to your toes and lifting up to your chest. Together like the tail of a seal, and then lift your chest up even more, breathing into your entire spine. Lower the legs down carefully to start. Down your forearms, then stack your palms. Bring your forehead on top and let your hips rock from side to side. And then you can find your heels to your bum, find a reverse windshield wiper on your belly. Come back down. Good, and then from there, we'll start to find a little stretch for the chest. You can take your arms in line with your shoulders, tend your left fingertips next to your pec, and then roll onto your right hip and step your left foot in front of your right knee. Now, I recommend the use of one of your blocks and taking that underneath the right side of your face. So this way the neck is not compromised at all, which is very important for the neck and the health of the cervical spine. Keep that, and that might be enough. If you wish for a bit more in your chest and your pec and your arm and shoulder are alright, then bring the left arm up. As you bring the left arm up, you can turn the palm away from you and then take it down behind your low back. In addition, you can roll your hips a bit more forward, lift your right hip, and then pin the left palm down with the right hip and breathe. Sighing out. Inhale. And exhale. one more breath here. Then roll your hips forward to release the left hand if it's clamped. And then take your left palm down, stack your legs, and then you can slowly release the pressure of the right arm onto your belly. And then start to switch sides. So take the left arm out, tent the right fingertips right beside your right pec, roll onto your left hip with the hip stacked, and step your right foot in front of the left knee. Take that block beneath the left side of your face. Now from here, reach your right arm up. Turn the palm away. Take the top of the hand to the low back. Roll forward and lift your left hip up. And then place your hip on top of your hand. And breathing into the left side of your arm and pec and chest, shoulder girdle. Few more breaths here. And then carefully release as you take the right arm to the right and up to the ceiling. Place the right palm down, stacking your legs. Onto your belly. Take your left arm down by your side, as well as your right arm. Let your chin rest, your forehead rest. And just stay here for a few breaths. A few breaths into your belly. Letting those breaths ripple through your nervous system, through your spine. Thread the other underneath and help yourself as you roll onto your back. Let your legs rock from side to side. We'll take a nice restorative two knee twist before Shavasana. So take a bolster between your legs and thighs. And if you have a second bolster, then take that bolster on the left side, so when you bring your legs across center to the left, that second bolster can act as a cushioning for the bottom of the left shin and calf. And let your arms come out in line through shoulders. Breathing in. And out. Let your gaze turn whichever direction or let it stay to the ceiling. as we start to wind down, let your breath reflect that state of resting and digesting. Contentment and ease. And then inhale, come on back to center. Take the bolster that was on the left across to the other side. And let the legs fall over to the right. And then let your arms in line with your shoulders. One more breath here. Inhale to center. Hug your knees in and out. Now we'll take a brief roll to the side, press up to our seats, and set up for a restorative supported back bend as our closing shavasana. So you'll require, if you have them available, two foam blocks at the back of your mat. One will be flat and one will be on its second height, and they'll be touching the form in L shape. Then you'll take a chip foam block on top of the bottom block, so that way there's a bit of elevation for the chest, and take a bolster over top of that. If you have a second chip block, or even a blanket or pillow that you can sit on, I encourage that to be placed in front of the bolster, and then your bum come on top. Then you can take a second bolster, which will go underneath your knees, like so. And then the third bolster, if you do have a third bolster, then you can always place this third bolster over top of your thighs for a little extra gravity. Or place the second bolster or the third bolster on its edge and place your ankles and calves over top, and then laying back onto your elevated restorative shavasana. And you can always take that second bolster underneath on its edge as well if you want to have even more height. Once you arrive there, you're most welcome, if you have an eye cover of any kind, to apply. over your forehead, your eyes. And then let your arms rest down by your sides as you settle into your Shavasana. Take another full breath in. And sigh it out. Fill yourself back up.
You had no feeling.
slowly start to come back into a deeper breath. Moving your arms and legs, awakening the nervous system. Taking the eye cover off to the side. And then place your feet down, and rolling over to your left side, pressing up to a seated position to close practice with. Notice how you feel in the mind, in the body, in the spirit. Sometimes the practices that move slower and that are more gentle can be just as or even more profound than those that might be more powerful and fast and fiery and very heated. It's okay to turn inward and cool down in order to warm up deep within self. Center. Take an inhale through your nose. And an exhale through your mouth. Take another inhale. And exhale. One more. Inhale to Om. Thank you so much for practicing. Namaste.